Okay, so I'm back. Sorry, I'm doing some tests. So I will start again. Just waiting for the stream to restart. We'll destroy the previous stream. Okay, we are back. So what I was saying is now tonight we are going to have a stream session about making a programmer for an IoT device I've built a year ago. It's a stick tracker, so it's a device I'm working on the design now, an industrial product which is ready, and it's basically a tracker made on ultra low cost technology. And this tracker needs to be programmed for being used, and so I need to have a solution to massively program it, and also to let my customer able to program it on themselves. And so I need to design the programmer. And for this, I'm using a Raspberry Pi with a special hat I've made. So here is the hat. It's really a simple thing. You don't see it here because of the light. Yeah, there is a STM32 in the middle with a custom firmware I've made. And this custom firmware know how to speak to this device to program it. So that was a huge work I did at the beginning of the year to reverse engineer how this chip work to make it programmable from that board. So it's basically this one, and we have here a connector to go to a programming board, where we have a SIM card connector. And as you see on the bottom of the device, there is also SIM card pins, so we can just stick them together. So I have some 3D printed part for this. During the live session, you're gonna have some noise because I have a 3D part that is in printing in progress. This 3D part is to fix this board in the box. So the other things we are going to play with tonight is this. So this is composed in two parts. One part is this. This is a Raspberry Pi Compute module 3+. Okay, it has 16 gigabytes of flash on it, and I have this board, which was really interesting for me. This board is a I/O board for a compute module, but what was really interesting to me is that this board is supporting PoE. So it means that I can power this board only with an Ethernet cable when I have a switch with PoE, which is the case. So you see, if I plug it to the Ethernet, you see the lights. So you see, just that cable allows to power. So it's really easy to install, to deploy on an industrial environment. You just have one cable to use, so that's cool. And I mean, even if there is no PoE, we can use a PoE injector, so that's easy. So I can just put it here, and now the board is working together. So I need to have some setup of that board before getting started. The first thing is here. On this board, the board is a Waveshare board, so they are doing pretty good hardware and it's not expensive. And so on this board we have different things. We have so the Ethernet, which is a power. Well, I'm sorry, we're gonna have a lot of noise. We have the Ethernet connector. We have a power USB power connector, so this is cool if you do not have PoE. And we have a slave USB connector. This one is going to be really interesting. Is the one we are going to use to connect the Mac to the board to access the EEPROM inside the flash memory inside the compute node to deploy the Raspbian Linux. So this one is important. We have a serial to USB connector also, so it's a direct access to the serial port. Basically, I'm using the serial port on my board, so it means that I need to disable this part. And for this, there is some jumper here, so I can switch off this jumper to remove this this part. On the bottom, we also have a a flash extension. I won't use this, but it's there. And after, we have different extension. What is also important is I want to use it as a PoE, so I can enable here the PoE function, or eventually I could disable it if expected. And there is also some feature for a fan, but I'm going to try to not use a fan for this. So basically here we have the setup. So once we have the setup, I can plug it here. So now it's powered, and as I explained, I'm going to to plug the USB on the slave connector. This USB goes to my computer, and so now I will be able to access this this compute module. And for this, I need to use a Windows solution. So I'm gonna switch, my screen, and we are going to start a VM for doing this. Okay, I'm gonna move this VM to here. Okay, I'm gonna start a VM where there is a tool to program the compute module. So. Basically, how does it work? We have a program that will install a bootloader on the compute module, and this bootloader will make the flash of the compute module available as an external drive. And so that external drive, I will be able to mount it on my computer, and then I will be able to flash it as any external drive. And I will deploy the Raspbian thanks to this. Oh, okay, Windows, there is an update, as always. So we are going to see that, and I'm going to deploy a Raspberry Pi OS, so basically a Raspbian new name. And tonight I'm going to try to do a little change to avoid using a keyboard to set up the SSH. Let's see if that works. Okay, that's good. Getting an update 100%. Next 5 minutes, 100%. Do not. Yes, starting. Okay. Okay, so yesterday the tool has been installed, so. I should not have to do it once again. Okay. So I need at first. I'm gonna check my HDD printer. Yeah, okay, that's good. Well, this Windows is slow tonight. What is the name of the tool? I don't remember the name of the tool. RPI. Yes, RPI boot. So RPI boot. So let's run RPI boot. It's opening a lot of windows. Oh, Okay, so it's waiting for the device. So now on the USB, I'm going to connect the broadcast BCM2710. And yeah, you see that as soon as I've connected it, the boot code is sent, and now it's waiting. So there is a reboot at this step, so that's why it's waiting for it. So I need to reconnect it again. So we have the second stage. Okay. And so now we have the hard drive, which is installed, but which is not readable. Which makes sense because this is a fresh new drive, empty drive. So now I'm able to mount the drive to my computer, and so I can use. I don't know why it's not here, but okay, not a problem. Sorry for the noise of the printer. So let's go to Ballet Nature. I really love that tool for flashing Linux. It's cool. So I'm gonna flash from a file. The file is up the Raspi OS, and the target is a compute module, 16 gigabyte compute module. So I can select it. And we can go for flash. And here we go. So this is taking a few time to do it. During that time, I will going take a look to my printing. And the printing is in progress, so that's cool. And during this time, I'm going to prepare the next step. In the next step, I could have a make file for this, but I can have a make file for this. I have some different operation for building the target, so potentially I can do it in the file. And I have different type of module. I have an installation for a standard Raspberry Pi, and here for a compute module 3. So. Nothing rocket science there. Okay, flashing is in progress. Flashing in progress, and the make file is quite ready. But you see, this is on Mac. The only reason I needed Windows was only to execute the RPI boot stuff. So it was only for this. Just to save time for next time. So I can close some update again. Okay, during that time the flashing is terminating, and now there is validation. So I can share with you what is going in the next step. So in the next step, I will deploy all what I need for making this programmer running. And so I'm using Ansible for doing this. I have a two-step Ansible, so I have two different playbook I'm using. You see that the first one is install and the second one is deploy. Because if I have two steps, is due to the way we can connect to the Raspberry Pi. So during the install phase, during that phase, in fact, I'm accessing the Raspberry Pi with the Pi user and Raspberry password, which is the default for a fresh new installed Raspberry Pi. And so I'm doing update on the system and stuff like this. I mean, really classical things. And I'm also configuring the way I will be able to log on this Raspberry Pi. So basically, just authorizing a PI user to connect and using an authentication with a certificate instead of a password. And so for this reason, once this playbook is finished, I use another playbook with a connection, which is different because I'm using a certificate instead of using a password at the end of this playbook. So on this second playbook, I'm installing all the functional stuff. So as I say, what I want to deploy and execute is a jar file. It's a Spring Boot solution, Spring Boot software, and so I need to install a GDK, the different component in the software, and I also install printer drivers and things like this because some version of this programming system also have a printer to print the stickers on the back of the device. And at the end, I also need to configure the serial line. Yesterday, I spent some time about this part because the serial configuration, I mean, physically, the serial in the different version of Raspberry Pi is, I don't say it's a maze, but it's really changing. You have a hardware serial on some version and software on some other, and it's a bit of a mess. I will talk a bit more on this during the installation. So now the flash process is done. I need tonight to check something. I have a colleague that give me some interesting information, but I was expecting to see the volume here to be able to change something, because you know the issue we have, I mean it's not an issue, but right now I have a Raspberry Pi. I'm able to reboot it, and to access it, but I need to have a SSH access to execute my Ansible scripts. And the problem is that SSH by default is not enabled. And so we can do that by just having a SSH file on a boot partition. But for this, I need to be able to access the boot partition. But I think that once the flash has been made, I don't think that I'm going to try to switch it. I'm going to do another thing in parallel. I'm going to plug it to a screen so I would be able to see what is happening on the Raspberry Pi. But when you know, I would like to avoid that step. Okay, so currently I'm going to try to remove the slave connection and try to restart it. In fact, I would like to see, yeah, I have the boot partition, so that's cool. That's cool. So now, as I have the boot partition, normally on the boot partition, I can create a file. I can create an empty file, which is just a SSH. If I understand well, that's enough. Okay, with nothing in it, if I understand well. And that file, I can copy it and boot. I can copy it and boot. So the idea of printing something in parallel of having a stream is not a good idea. And I know that now. It's not a big issue when I'm doing classical hacking, but when there is some people with me, it's not cool for you. So I'm sorry for this. So where is my stick tracker? Stick tracker. Ansible files and SSH. I'll try this. So, and there is another question. What would be good, and if I could set up a default IP address, because I need a screen to see the IP address. So, if I could set up a default IP address, I could execute my script on this IP address. That would be really cool. Set up default IP address. Good. Setting a static IP address. Yes, there is a command line point text. But I would like to put this IP address. I mean, I don't want to put it forever. I want to have instead of DHCP. Find something, so this could be interesting. Command line. Command line text. IP address. Basically, if I could create a second virtual Ethernet. I can do something at the edge 0. I can also post set up the ETH. Let's try something like this. So I have zero. So it's way down. Okay, let's try. Not sure it's gonna be a good idea, but let's do some try. It'd be cool to have the detail of what it is. Set to IP the sound at mass 2000, get away address. You might need to disconnect from many wireless network to make this work. Okay. Something like this. Okay. I'm sure that there are some good documentation somewhere on Raspberry Pi, but it's not always easy to find. I would like to keep ETH0 as a DHCP, but not sure that we can do that. Okay, maybe I can force and maybe change it after. So let's do a try like this. Blah blah. I mean, I don't think in fact it's gonna help me, because even when I will switch to DHCP, you know what I think right now. That was a good idea to have a fixed IP address, because I would not have to find the right address to be used. But the problem is that this address won't be able to route on my network, and so I will have to change this address through DHCP. And once I will have done this, I won't be able to know what is the address. So basically, it's kind of eggs and chicken, so maybe it's not a good idea, but it was good to see that it's possible to do something around this. Okay, so I was not able to modify this tool, so no. Okay, maybe okay, so sorry for this time. Sorry, that's life of debugging. So now I can boot the device. So I will just switch it off and on. And you won't see anything because it's on another screen. But the Raspberry Pi is booting. So on my other screen, we have the Raspberry Pi slash splash screen, and now it's booting. And if that works well, the SSH should start, and I will also be able to see the IP address on the second screen, and so I will be able to access the device. I have a good news, is that the printing is terminated. So, noise is going to be finished. We'll see that once it's finished. So my Raspberry Pi is currently booting, and my IP address is okay. Oh wow! In fact, the IP address, there is a default IP address. In fact, it's interesting. There is a I did not do this part. I need to check that because I have two IP addresses, in fact, that maybe that could solve my my question. It's better for you like this. So SSH P at, and the IP address is, that's the one that has been attributed by my network. Raspberry, okay, and so yeah, I have two IP addresses, but that's a bit surprising. So normally, so that's interesting. So what I've done has been saved, and so that's interesting because By putting this, my ETH has two addresses, one which has been given by my DHCP, so the one I was using for connecting to the Raspberry Pi, and that one that I have fixed in the command line point text. So basically, I could connect through this IP address to get the IP address. To get the DHCP IP address that has been obtained. So that's interesting. It's something I can do. I can script. Oh, that's cool. I won't script with this, but with this, it's gonna be better. And so I can create a script. I can create a script here. Get IP. Okay, and so this get IP. Get RPI address. Okay, so okay, so the host is 16.0.1. I think I can write it like this. I need the way to connect initial. So I can also use initial.yaml. I can use a target like this. Okay. Not sure. But I think that it's a target. Cool. Target, but I'm going to create another inventory. New file. Initial. Inventory because that one I need to change it every time. So initial inventory. Okay, and so it's 16.0.1. Okay, get IP. So it connects to target with this and the task. So the task I need to do, it's IP. What is the more easy for me? That everything has been correctly configured. Okay, makes sense. So the question is how I can get the right IP address. If I can need to find the how I can do something like IP, IP. I need to find the IP address. Alors, I want the address on a device which is a TH1. Want to set a device. But maybe I will have another issue if I do that. That's interesting, but it could be a bit more complicated for right after because my software is also getting the IP address. I don't know what IP address it's gonna show. So that's okay. That's another question I will have to solve after. Sorry, not clear. So I want to get a filter on ETH. I'm sure that I can select what ETH I want to get, but otherwise that's cool. Blah blah blah. Option version, human statistic detail result family. Okay, blah 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 blah. 1.4. Okay. Loop RC size. Timestamp, name, color, brief, pretty. Google, save me. Linux. Assigned to ETH0, blah 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 blah. If config, no, I want IP. That was too easy. It's not what I want to do because there's no detail on if config. There is no if config was too easy. Up, 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 up. IP ADDR show, TH0, IP filter the line, I'm not interested here. As if I add -4. No, I put -4 here because I want only IPv4. No, -4 was an option of IP. Oh, so I'll do it differently. Pipe grep. Pipe grep init. Okay. Pipe grep minus v 162.0.16.0.1. Cool. Pipe. Yes. So that could work to get the IP address. Oh. Okay. So syntax Ansible command. So command. I think that it's better to do something like this. No, I'm not sure of what I'm doing. So it's not command, but command. Okay. Command. Command. Okay. And I want to register the result. I can try debug var HTTP IP. I think it's stdout, I'm not sure. Stdout. Okay. So I'm going to try this. Normally it should fail. With lots of error as every time I'm where am I? Okay. So I want to do that to execute this playbook, so Ansible playbook get IP means inventory, which is initial inventory. So vars file. Vars file, yes, this is a problem. I hate YAML name. Let's no missing logical. Debug. Okay. So let's see if this is working or not. If I want to do a search thing, I need to have a network reaching this IP. So network, where are you? Okay, and let's add a network. Sense. Create and manually, and so says 16.0.250.55.55.0 no router apply. Okay, so now. But I'm not on the right machine. I'm executing this through. No, it should be okay. Can I ping it? I can ping the machine. Okay, and so if I can ping the machine, okay, I can ping the machine just to ensure that I've no. Okay, so SSH P at 16.01. Yes. Okay, so it works, and so my Ansible should be able to connect. Maybe it was just the time for the network to be up. Yes. Okay, so now, yes, I've seen that the way I'm passing the command is not really cool. Let's try it like this. Solved this issue recently. Can I try something like this? No. I've solved this. Don't like the pipe or no, it's register. Register is there. Okay, there is the issue. same error. Previous error was not that one. No. I have to see what's happening. Should be good. So. So Dev is duplicating or backslash pipe is a garbage. Just let's try. Just verify the command. Okay, so the syntax is good and the way of writing it is not good. I know that I've solved this few times ago. Difference kind of it. And I'm not sure the way I've made I fix that. I think here it's only one big. No, it has split into a lot of things. I think I was using something like this, but it apparently no, I don't like this. And if I try on, yeah, oh no. Strange. No such fire directory. RC. There's no RC. This is good. We tried to I don't like this. No such file on directory. Why no such file on directory? No, it's okay. I can execute it as P. Try just something more easy. Okay. Name command register. If you watch the the video, the stream, maybe you start saying I have the solution. Let me know. YAML is a mess. Okay, so back on this one. This one was not bad. The syntax here was not bad. But at the end, I don't understand why I get. No. To see that I am okay. That one normally was doing something, executing something. Oh, line 18. Oh, shit. Okay, so now it should not work, and I can just try. This so don't like here. That one should not be here. Let's try it like this. Blah blah blah. Let's try to protect all that stuff. No, fade changed. Delta and non-zero return code. Dev is duplicate. Or pipe the garbage. So it don't like okay, so it was better like this. Because like this it was executed. No, not more executed. I've been able to get it executed. I don't remind how I did that. Okay, so we are progressing. So it's like it is trying to execute. The results. No, it's still the same thing. IP editor show grep. No such file or directory. Just write the command. Okay. So this is the command I'm trying to pass. So this is basically working. But when I'm trying to execute the command itself, I get a no such file or directory. Thank you. sure we can pipe something to echo basically. Have a dot. Try something more simple. Ah, interesting. I'm quite sure I've been able to do something like this. Okay. So the problem is the code, but it don't want the pipe. I'm not sure you want to protect all the pipe. I'm quite sure. I'm sure I did not do that. But maybe I did not protect with double code, maybe with a simple code. Okay. I'm not really confident here. No. No, 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 no. Let's try something. Don't like, in fact, it's a pipe, that is a problem. So Ansible command pipe. Maybe it's not a shell. Oh, okay. Okay, this is why it's not working. Insupported parameter name shell. Oh yeah, it's shell and not command. Okay. Maybe this was the reason why I've been able to do it by the past, and was not able, yes, to do it that time. So no. Okay. So, yes, I'm able to get the IP address, and now I want this IP address to be created in an inventory file, okay, in the local inventory file. So for this, I have Ansible block file, Ansible block file here. Okay, so we can, but it's on local host, so I need to create another things, create local host, create local host inventory file, okay. Localhost become no on any or fatal ah. So I need to create a new file. More than a, in fact, it's not a block file. I want to create a new file. I don't know if I can do that with block file. Blah blah. Create a new file if it does not exist. But I also want to create it if it exists. Mod, permission, owner, path. Blah 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 blah. Create a new file. Propose file path dead touch. Yeah, but it's not. Oh, yeah. Base content copy dest. Yeah, okay, can do just like this. Copy dest. So it's a Ansible playbook. I'm not sure. Ansible playbook location var. Yes. Remote, pass. Okay, Empire, I think. Playbook dear. Tac. Thank you, Visual Studio. Playbook dear slash in event inventory. Okay, and in this file, I want to have content. And in the inventory file, I want to have this. So, oops. Target. And on the next slide, next line, I want to get my variable, which is dhcp.stdout. Just checking std out. Yes, it is what I want. Okay, cool. And that's it. Okay, let's give it a try. Name, create inventory file. Control host. Oh, host is not valid. Host, sir. I think I already did that mistake today. So I get the IP address and then I create a file containing this IP address, but this is not working. Oh, yes, the variable is not defined, so I need to pass. I don't remember to. How we do that? We can pass a variable from one it's Ansible
is different than Hotspur. Okay, cool. System was launched as set the virus name. Okay. Can set facts and other together. That's it. Fact. Set fact IP VH VH CP IP equal. And then to get a fact, it's something like the host vars. Give it a try. Localhost, it's pas good. Gonna have a lot of things normally. That's boring. Okay. So. Okay, we have many things. And it tells me that there's no Osvar. I can get Osvar from hosts OST vars 16.16.0.1 and I want to get fact. I need to get the fact the HTTP IP. Basically I could do it differently in fact, because the IP address is also part of the fact, so I could get it from the fact in fact, maybe, but yeah, okay. Basically I could get it from here, IP4 secondaries, I couldn't get it from that entry, it would be really more easy, but okay. I spent a lot of time to make the script working differently, so it's not really same thing for 100 times. Copy, paste, and search could be more efficient. Expecting to find it, but okay. It's really, really long. Wow, it's, oh yeah. Okay. Copy. Yes, the DHCP IP, okay, it could work like this. But this to verify it could work. Basically it could. Ozva has not reviewed the HTTP IP. Okay, where is the HTTP IP? Yes, that's what's working. I can remove this. Okay, and I can check the inventory file, and the inventory file contains the right information. So that has been a bit longer, a long things, but you know. So the purpose of all of this is to not have to set up anything on the Raspberry Pi and not getting the IP the IP address delivered by the DHCP for the initial installation. So it means that to in the README I can document README. Yeah, I can document this. Then okay, deploy the software, but in fact changing the UART connection from Windows after this weekend flash the Raspberry on it. Open the flash disk in Finder and create SSH empty file in the slash boot to enable SSH. Edit command line dot text file to adding. So just let's see, command line, and then command line, copy, okay, no, I want to add this, okay, so that's the initial setting. And now to deploy software, it's make
build to the CM3. So make build CM3, it's gonna do make file. So the first playbook Ansible playbook, it's get IP dot YAML -- I, and its initial inventory. So that first script is getting the IP, the DHCP IP to it creates the inventory file. So then the inventory file can be executed. And so what also I can do in this get IP is to remove the command line, because I don't really like to have command line with this at the end. So how can I modify? Maybe I can. I don't know. There is no cat slash boot command line. I need to filter the part with IP in it. Something like pipe tr-s to split space and replace it by backslash n. So I can do that. Get minus v ip equal. Yeah. Pipe tr-s backslash n. Okay. Yeah, cool. This command is cool. Yep. So even if we have a slightly different things, name remove the default IP address. So why I'm doing this? It could seem looks. A bit strange, because this IP could be there. Is my because my software is getting the IP address of the ETH, and it reports it through a log system. So that way, when you plug the system on a network, it reports its local IP address to be able to do some administration automatically. And as the default address is 172. Address, it will report that one, so it's gonna be a mess in my software to find the right address and so on. So by doing this, I should be able to avoid this issue. That work. Now, every time you do something, permission denied. Oh shit! Oh yeah, because I'm not root. Okay, it's not a big issue. Cool. I have set up the right command line. Yeah, there's no return. Okay, perfect. So, okay. And so I can execute my make file.
Just checking, make file. So make file, I'm doing this getting IP and modifying the stuff. Maybe I should not, I have to be careful because if I execute two times, yeah, it's not an issue because it's getting from, yeah, okay. No, that should be okay. So I can do make, build, no, CM3, it's not that one. CM3 is here. So I can build CM3, bing. And normally everything should work step by step. I just add a, okay. Okay. Why? Oh yeah, okay, checking. I need to SSH. Checking. There is an option for this. Oh shit, there is a Ansible. Ansible. I just don't remember the name of the variable to put the option. One and deploy. Yeah, I had the so it was already there here, and so I have a super good. Okay. So we go on the second one, this time it has been able to connect, and yeah, so it's on the way, so that's cool. We have a certain time for the configuration, and during that time I can apply a bit with this. I'm gonna change this, get more video. So you know, at the end, the other board, at the end I want to have the board. So the board, that box. So I need to fix the board in the box. That's why I print the small piece of plastic to do this. So I need to check. So it's not working. Yeah, it could work. Because the box, okay, it's not so bad. This screws. Remove these screws because otherwise it's so high. I can't close the box because the A of my box is just of what I can do. It's not easy to put a plastic box. As you can see, this board is too large. I also add methods. I'm doing this kind of stuff. I mean, every time it's fun, and there's a retry. It's working better, but the system is great. Fixation is very good. It's a bit just too hard. But see, is different. I need to mention how good or not. So if I want to go here, yeah, that's good. So during the same time, we have the back on the screen, so it's still in progress. There is all the Raspbian update, so it's quite long. So I can go back on my FreeCAD during that time. And so basically, so my piece of plastic is like this, and so what I want to do is to okay, I can do it. So the problem with that cube is a bit, it's too small and is a bit too, so in terms of size at first it should be 85. Okay, so if 85, it means that 86 is recommended. And now I say that I want, I can be more. So this is about 3 millimeters. The right direction. So maybe that one. No, the other one. Yeah. So that one should sound better. No, here I also have some issue. This one, so that time it's the big one. So that now that one, so that one I need to have it larger, like I think that
3 millimeter or so. So let's have 90. Yes, that's the right direction. And so on that one, I can 60. Yeah, that sounds better like this. I think I should be really better like this. The other point, but it's quite a feature. It's a bit difficult to. In fact, it's because there are it's a bit difficult to explain, but the way the fixation are made, it's not really cool. In fact, well, if I put some force. But the position for this one is not really good. I'm not sure it's something important. There's two small cylinder. Not this one.
This one does what does it?
For the small one, yeah, they are 1 millimeter radius, it's really too small. I can try 1.5. Let's see, 1.5. Okay, and the eighth could be also like 5. And here I can make it just a bit larger for now. There's a small one, so this one, yeah, I can have them a little bit larger. To simplify, okay, the way it is. Okay, cool, and the main cube, this one can also be 1 millimeter. It's more. That's to be able to screw here with a better result. Okay, I'm a bit suspicious about this one. Not sure. It seems to be really near the corner. I will see that later. I won't start the printing right now because it's really noisy. We'll see that. So the long configuration step has been passed. So now Java has been installed. All the refresh has been made. Now it's another installation for some script for printing, even if here it's not really necessary. So now I will have the deployment of my software. And I need to export during that time. I'm going to export. If you don't select the device you want to export on that tool, it exports nothing. Export and export, yes, replace, cool, and here I can, yeah, I can click it. I will do that a bit after, just getting this installation finished. Uh, I also need to do a test, as I need to change a configuration file. Because the serial is not the same. As a default one, as an other Raspberry, an other system is TTY AMA 0, but here the okay, the installation is done. Yes. That's cool. So that's okay. Now, I need to reboot. That's something I could automate also. I will automate the. Okay. I need to have a file. I close it too fast. I have a config file. I want that config file to override the setting. I'm not sure if it will override or not. So I need a. Sorry, there's some password. So configuration point property. I can try something like name create configuration properties file. So it's a new file I want to create. I can do. Line in file. I just have one line to put. Path slash root slash root slash slash configuration point proper keys. Serial name, and it's not TTY AMA 0, but I'm not sure I can slash TTY. I think it's serial 1 or TTY S0. I think it's TTY S0. So I check that this line is in the file, and then I reboot minus name reboot. Why reboot? Last reboot. Share. Makes sense. Just executing the last command. Inventory. And it's the last script. Executing everything. Deploy CM3. Okay. Okay, let's try this. And if that work, I have to put the hat on the compute module. Yep, it's here. So now I have the hat in the compute module. I think I need to find some space for. Oh, by the way, when the hat will be in place, we'll have the cable, the connector also. I'm afraid that I'm gonna get an error by doing a reboot. Ah, the file does not exist. Okay, I want you to create the file. Ansible line in file, and I want to create the file if not existing. Create, yes. State present. Create, yes. So there is only one thing I did not automated is the insertion of the SSH and the modification of the command line dot text when creating the and the command line basically I could do it because it's just I need to do it before the reboot. Yes. It was a 1 second before. Okay. Copy and I can create here a file. As I can just copy the two files as the file is the same every time. So it's see what I'm doing. Oh no. File, new file. Second line the text took and in the readme I have so command line point the text I have it and in a readme in fact is and copy file slash SSH and file slash the text into so I just have to copy the two file and restart the P install. Yeah, so now the installation is really optimized. Okay, I just had the reboot that is executed. So now I'm not accessing through PI this IP. If I want to get the IP, I have to take a look to the inventory. Yeah, I'm not in the right. inventory. So it's that one. Yeah, that was this IP. Yeah. And I need to use the key to access the file. Yeah, I'm on it. So I should have a Java, but I'm not sure. /dmp Java. And okay, so I've tried to override the serial setup, but it has not been overrided, so that's why it has not started. But I mean, it's gonna be a task for tomorrow. Just check that I have configuration, and in I have tty at 0, and just to do my test, /dev tty, and I have tty at 0. Okay, if I do tty get update install minicom just to test it. Okay, and do a minicom -b, dev tty as 0. Okay, so that's cool. I'm able to access the serial. The only problem is that my Java code is using the configuration for the serial port, and this configuration is inside the jar file, and I have to modify a bit my jar file to remove this serial, or even have the code to search into the configuration.property instead of the configuration file inside the jar file to override the configuration. So that's going to be something to do for next day, because I'm a bit tired tonight. Basically the installation has been automated better than it was before, so I have less manual operation to do, and I can deploy a new board automatically thanks to this, with no keyboard requirement or thing like this. So that's cool. I mean I'm doing this for being able to produce 100 or 200 of them, so I really need to make it automated and easy to do. So basically it's what I achieved tonight, so that's good. Last things, I'm going to store this in my Git. And basically the inventory is not needed, but okay. Automate CM3. And push. Oh, that's cool. Okay, so that's the end for the stream tonight. It was not really dynamic tonight, less than yesterday. You will see that, but I hope that it has been interesting for people who will take a look to it and see what is my hacker life device maker. Bye, and see you on this 91. Don't hesitate to follow me on Twitch to see the next live coming, and also you can follow me on Twitter to be notified when I will have a next session. I will try to have a different session like this one, so stay tuned. Bye.